Hello from Cinco Ranch Branch Library. My name is Barbara, and today we're going to show you how to decorate wooden letters with your favorite book covers. This is a great craft for teens or anyone who just loves to read. And the final product can be used as decoration in your room or anywhere around the house. You'll need a wooden letter or multiple wooden letters. Between 8 and 12 inches is best. We're using 8-inch letters here. You can choose your initial or initials, or spell out a word with the letters. We've chosen to spell out the word read, so here's the R for read. Next, you'll need Mod Podge and a brush to apply it. You'll need a working surface, probably waxed paper. Then you'll need printouts of the book covers on regular paper. You'll need multiple covers for each letter. How do you choose the covers you want to use? Well, you can use your favorite book covers, or you can use ones that have a theme that you like, or even ones that just have the same color that look good together. We have chosen YA book covers for our project. We chose these particular covers because they are visually appealing and the colors go well together. Let's take a quick detour and talk about book covers. We're always told not to judge books by their covers, but we all do. What first grabs your eye when you're browsing books? The spine or the cover? Yes, the title plays a part too, but book covers are designed to fascinate us and draw us in. A book cover has multiple purposes. First and foremost, it is designed to protect the book. This purpose has been diminished in the era of e-materials, but it is obviously still very important for physical books. The book cover also serves as a hook for the book. This role is gaining prominence in the era of e-materials and the internet. The cover should attract the right type of reader, correctly positioning the book in terms of marketing. So back to our craft. We have the first book cover we're using. I want to get most of the picture. So I'm going to take this R and place it on this side of the picture, kind of angle it so I get a lot of the letters and the actual antlers. And then I'm going to trace around with my pencil. I'm going to leave a margin so we can wrap it over the side of the letter. And this margin is just for cutting. Then I'm going to take the next cover and we're going to lay it over this other side here. So this other cover is going to cover this, the curves of the R. So I just trace this. So now I'm going to cut out the letters. All right, the letters have been cut out. So we're gonna put this one on first because I'm gonna put this other side on top. So it's gonna look like that. So we're gonna lay here like this and just kind of position how I wanna do it. I want to make sure that the white, since we have a border from the picture, that the white isn't on the front of the letter. So you want to make sure by just folding it manually to see that it doesn't have any white showing. So that looks good. So now we're going to take the Mod Podge and you're going to paint a layer on the letter. And it's just the front. You don't have to worry about the sides right now. Try not to get a lot of glops of the, so it doesn't have, so it's nice and smooth, smooth surface. Okay? And you're gonna put this paper on top of it, how you had it before. And again, we're gonna make sure that there's no, that you have places to fold over on the sides and that the white isn't showing. So smooth it out as best you can. Okay, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna cut this section here and then put this on top, since you don't need this. Okay, I'm gonna glue this other section now. And I'll just glue over the remaining paper. Again, make sure you don't have the white showing when it curves over. And you should be good. Okay, now you have to wait and let it dry. While we wait for the Mod Podge to dry, let's take another look at book cover design. A lot of elements go into cover design. Cover designers can use images, fonts, placement, colors, and a whole host of design elements to create an effective cover. Let's look at some of the components. Very large typography. Sometimes the focus is on the title, other times it is on the author, and sometimes on both. A quick blurb. Although a more detailed synopsis is usually available on the inside cover or back cover, the front cover sometimes has a brief tagline or quote of praise. Relatively small, emblematic imagery. A short reading line. This is typically seen in relatively small font. This provides any additional information, such as movie tie-ins, New York Times bestselling author, and so on. In the example here, you can see all of these elements. Let's bring it all together and look at the covers we chose for our craft. Let's look at Leigh Bardugo's Shadow and Bone. The letters interlace with the stag's antlers. A stag is central to the storyline as the object of a quest. The colors work well together and they have complementary colors in them. They have large but a readable font with a small reading line about the author. Now look at Lainey Taylor's Strange the Dreamer cover. Again, the colors go well together. One of the characters screams moss, hence the moths on the picture. The story is about a land called Weep. Back to our craft. So the front covers have dried, so we turn it over, and in the curves that you may have on your letter, you'll need to cut little slits so you can fold it back easily. So I've done that already. So what you wanna do is have enough so that when you glue this edge, you can just apply it to the edge there and it's smooth. So I've done that. I know it's not pretty, it doesn't have to look pretty because this is the back, no one will see that. So you just get some glue, put it on the edge, because we're gonna fold the edges over. So you're just gonna lay it like that and press it hard so it stays. You may have to hold it a little bit. And then do that for all of the edges. Okay, so this is the back. We've glued up the corners here and the edges. You'll notice when you do have a curve, you're gonna get some spaces that you're gonna have to fill in with extra, just a little bits of paper that you fill in, you cut off from that same cover. So once you get the little spaces filled in, it'll be like a complete coverage And then afterwards, when you get that done and you like the way it looks, then you just cover this with a coating of the Mod Podge, and then you'll be done. Okay, this is our final project. We spelled out read, so you can put this on your bookcase, or if you want, you can individually hang the letters on your wall. For those interested in learning more about book covers, you might want to check out The Look of the Book or The Lost Books of Jane Austen. Be sure to pay attention to the book covers when you're searching for a book or browsing our extensive library collection. Once you finish reading the book, decide for yourself if the cover designer did a good job of representing the book's main ideas. For more information and resources, be sure to check out our catalog and website. You can also find more craft ideas on our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.